If you make a new article submission for publication in Wikipedia, then shortly thereafter, an actual human is going to check out your draft and evaluate it according to certain criteria. If your content passes that evaluation, then it's published in Wikipedia or remains published in Wikipedia. But if your content fails that evaluation, it's going to be sent back to you for revision and correction. I'm going to explain to you in the briefest way that I can how to make sure your content passes that evaluation. How do you do it? My name is Lane Raspberry. I've evaluated thousands of submitted articles to Wikipedia. I know the criteria and I know what evaluators are looking for. The evaluation process has many steps and there's many exceptions. I'm not going to explain it in entirety. I'm just going to explain one particular kind of circumstance that if you can meet these criteria, your article is going to get published. Here it is. When you make your content submission, I want you to have at least 5 sentences. Each one of those sentences should cite a different source, and each one of those sources that you cite should be a reliable source that has significant coverage of the topic you're writing about in Wikipedia and that is independent of the subject of the Wikipedia article. A common misconception by new editors is that when they're making a Wikipedia article submission, that they should submit a large number of sentences. This is a misconception. This is not going to help your evaluation. This will not get you to pass. Instead of focusing on the quantity of the sentences, you should focus on the quality of the sources that you're citing. Your sources, again, should be reliable, have significant coverage, and be independent of the subject. If you want to have more than 5 sentences, that's fine, but every sentence that you submit should also have a new citation, because what the evaluators really want to see is the number and quality of the sources you're citing, not the number of sentences that you submit. Let's talk about those citations. I said they should be reliable. What constitutes reliability? There's a few ways you can figure that out. Of course, Wikipedia has documentation on this. If you look at reliability in Wikipedia, there's a long manual that explains in detail what reliability means. You don't need to read that. The easiest way for you to determine reliability is to take the sources that you have, bring them to your local library or your favorite online librarian, show them your sources and ask them, "Dear librarian, what do you think of these sources? Are they reliable?" Librarians are trained in information science. Wikipedia gets its standards for reliability from the field of library and information science. And if your librarian tells you that a source is reliable, then Wikipedia reviewers are also going to agree with that. Now, if you want to evaluate sources yourself, it's a bit difficult. Like I said, there's a manual, but I'm just going to give you a brief explanation that I think applies in many cases. Some people would disagree with this. But if you don't know what you're doing, you have no idea what reliability is, of course you can submit it to Wikipedia. The reviewers are going to tell you these things, but just check. Does the source have a named author? Does it have a named publisher? And does it have a date of publication? So this is so general, this is just my own opinion, but let me explain my way of thinking. If a source has a named author, then you know that somebody's professional reputation is at stake. You have somebody's actual name vouching for the quality of the content, and this publication is going to follow them throughout their career. This is why you look for an author. Now, if in your citation you can actually name the publisher, a publisher is an indication that there's some kind of editorial process in place for the writing of this article, and that not only do we know who the author is, but we also have an entire organization that has their reputation at stake for the quality of this kind of content. They're taking a certain amount of responsibility also. So it's a dual level of responsibility if you know the author and the publisher. Now, if you see a date of publication, that's an indication that the source you're citing is not to be discarded after a short amount of time. It's not ephemera. It's not gray literature. The publisher is expecting this article that you're citing to be around for a long time, perhaps read years after its publication. And so you know that the quality of it's higher because they're expecting their reputation to be carried with this article for many, many years in perpetuity. Now, many other people would have different ideas about reliability, but I've got to draw the line somewhere. if you don't have these things, you're still welcome to submit your content. If you know it's a reliable source, there's plenty of exceptions. I'm just stating some general rules. I said that the sources you cite should have significant coverage. This is easier to understand. What I mean by significant coverage is that the sources shouldn't just be a passing mention. That is, the subject of the source that you're citing should match the subject of the Wikipedia article that you're writing. They should be about the same thing. So for example, if you're writing a biography in Wikipedia, the ideal source to cite is somebody else who's written a biography of that same person. If, for example, you're citing a biography and then incidentally it mentions somebody else in their life, you can leave that up to Wikipedia, you can leave that up to a librarian. This isn't exactly what we're looking for. I don't want to discourage you, but this may not be significant coverage of that topic. I said that sources should be independent of the subject. What does that mean? Well, consider a biography. You can have a person publish their own biography on their own website. Of course, that's reliable. It's their life. They're reliable for talking about their life. And it may go into significant detail about their own life. They're talking about themselves. But this isn't independent. Wikipedia is not supposed to be a summary of what people write about themselves, of what corporations write about themselves or their products. Wikipedia is a summary of what people unaffiliated with a topic, people who have no financial stake in a topic, have said about this. So if you can demonstrate source reliability and depth of coverage, significance, and independence of the subject in each of your sources, it's very likely that the Wikipedia evaluators will look favorably on your submission and accept it. Of course, the evaluators would like to see you have more than 5 sentences and more than 5 sources. And if you have more content than that, feel free to submit it. But if you can get at least those 5 sentences and those 5 sources, I am telling you, this is my opinion, your article is going to pass the evaluation process. Your article will be published in Wikipedia. If you can't find at least 5 sources to cite, think about why that is. Do the best you can. Feel free to make your submission. And Wikipedia reviewers may still accept it. If you want to know more, Wikipedia has plenty of help forums. You can go into these help forums, submit your article draft there, and ask actual humans what they think of it, independent of the article submission process. Get a pre-evaluation if you like. This kind of support is always available to you. Thanks for considering Wikipedia. Thanks for submitting new article drafts.